Okay, here we are again. How about those imaginary numbers? I like how before Ukav is like, no, we can't kill Kintsugi's group. It's necessary to our plan, but now he's getting in our way. Good job, Ukav. Yay, we get all the dangerous jobs. I don't think a sailor is playing too much to Kazuki's talents here. I mean, I guess we somehow managed to successfully sneak into several bases so far, but I mean, the game itself even says that Kazuki's main go-to tactic is smash through everything. That's not exactly the hallmark of an infiltration unit. actually gave me shops rather rapid fire. I guess the question is, well, I guess that does answer the question. There is definitely a new weapon. I guess I don't really care about backpacks, since all of it's gonna be too heavy anyway. Not sure if I actually want to go for the 90% shield. I guess maybe I should do it on Ryogu. But I think it's almost better for Fam to be able to guard 12 attacks rather than 8. You know what, I think for now I'd rather have the durability. We'll see if that changes in the future. Oh, wow, there's not actually a grenade launcher upgrade. Not that I actually use them. Seems like, if a middle finger is a grenade users. Wow, exactly enough play. Alright, so I went to be able to change the shield anyway. Even if I wanted to. That's fine though. Oh man. I think I captured all that stuff. Look at the hit points on that shield arm. Real damage. But I don't think we're gonna get back to one-shotting parts most of the time, especially against the imaginary numbers. Because they have all the Vonzers that end up getting a boatload of hit points after upgrades. I'm so happy I'll get to see a real war with my own eyes. Who says that kind of thing? What a stealthy approach. Why is she shushing anyone? Talking over radios, it's not like it's actually coming from their Vonzers. Well, first step to infiltration. Rush headlong in a scout party. I cannot tell what's going on over there. Like, I'm not even sure what that thing has. I guess Pierce is usually a good default. Usually those ground vehicles will have cannons of some kind. Thank you. missile launcher and machine gun. Versus a melee. I guess, at the very least, it does mean we can kind of ignore most machines. Well, that's quite the climb. Also, I don't like the sound of fire support. My mean will be grenaded a whole bunch, which is never good. We have to break through this melee. Nice. That's kind of why I wanted to save Fam's action. Like, by chance, I was gonna have to just end her turn without doing anything. But we got rid of that arm, so... we actually messed that guy up pretty badly. Okay, we're gonna... man, what's this guy's fire support they're talking about? Well, I guess there's not really any good way to avoid getting grenaded if we're gonna get grenaded. Okay, it's nice that they're actually giving us time to go away. We have to do this to make him surrender so we don't get caught on the fire. Which is fine. These vehicles get absolutely destroyed by shield attack. Supposed to be a stun punch, not an eject punch. Not that I mind them. Okay, we'll save their turn. Do that. Oh well, not turning back. I guess it does raise the chances of Fam taking it out. If Alyssa wasn't gonna hit the body, at least Fam. Well, never mind. I guess we're not gonna be able to reach. Dodging. Even worth going for it. Okay, I'm not gonna waste the missile. We'll use it on the melee guy instead. Well, this guy's toast. Never mind, I was looking for a way to maybe scale the flank, but apparently whoever designed this map didn't want anyone to be able to do that. Oops, forgot about that. I don't think Ryoga took too much damage. Ready for the evasion. Man, I really wish she'd learned the skill from the Korra. We should be able to scale that area of the tree. Really now. Well, that turned out all right. I was kind of hoping to preempt him with a double assault, but forcing him to surrender also helps. Like, ideally, what would have happened if I hadn't forced to surrender is getting a double assault proc, shooting him and then punching his fist arm. We did all that body damage, just Bonzer me, still end up getting wrecked by the artillery strike. Okay then. He actually did get blown up. I'm kind of astonished. I'm surprised how he's not actually that far off of Nam's damage output. Like, she's way ahead of him in terms of weapon skill. I I don't think. I think his. Like, he doesn't have any free power on his. Or, no, wait. He has a little bit more free power. That might be why. Well, should have surrendered early, buddy. You have no one to blame but yourself. I think the Force Wall backpack is generally. Even though there's some tough battles, I'm starting to feel like that's all that's really needed. Because all those big expensive items generally mean that. You have to be in a very bad situation where they're necessary in the first place. Type play that should hopefully not be necessity. The enemy is probably using this special destroyer. Why didn't you tell us about this before we went out? Like, seriously, give us some intel if we're gonna be fighting super weapon platforms or something. Thank you. Ew, actually having music for overworld map movement. That doesn't happen too often. And then it cuts out after transition. Okay. I'm gonna end up swapping to fire here. Look for those cannons. Well, at least Miho is on the ball here. Well, this is kind of a bad time to be bringing it up. Like, bring it up before we're actually in the combat zone. But yeah, I might just stick with piercing, because we can shield the missile fire. And it's maybe a little more important that we reduce the damage we'll be attacking into. Really wish I could look at the map. But all we can see is this. Rifles and cannons, oh my. Actually, yeah, I'm really glad I didn't go for anti-missiles. So probably easier just to deal with these guys by shielding. And there's a lot more cannon units than I would have thought. There we go. That's what we're looking for. So after this battle, we'll have to change up her computer. We'll want a high proc computer. The arm smash is a super mean skill. I'm gonna be over it. Don't do that. We're gonna go here to bait the missile. Because otherwise, Kazuki's gonna end up beating it. And the chances of us getting a shield attack combo that just straight up kills the guy is gonna be pretty low. Maybe I should have moved one tile closer. Well, we can still attack with both, it's just because he has to use the shotgun. Means no chance of double assault. We're still technically, yeah, I think we're under cover of the building there. Need to move further anyway. Oh, okay. I'm not sure if we need to breach it with just one or all of them. Hey, she doesn't even have any real evasion. We didn't even take out his legs. What a ripoff. That was such a bad shot, too. Totally gets rid of getting all of right here. Really? You don't know why. guys, come on. And he had 17 health left. Okay, the sound is desynced. That's weird. It's not like I'm doing anything different. Pretty sure that my settings have changed. So like, is it me who's several seconds behind the game, or is it that the game audio is several seconds behind the video? Game audio is behind the game video. Really strange. This. I expected that to drop the sound for a second there, so I'm not sure if that'll actually help. You're just listening after weapon impacts? Well, maybe I'll finish this map up and then restart the stream. Where are you going? I don't even know why I use that missile against. Feels like it'd be a bit of a waste. Thank you. need to see if this makes us end the mission. No, we have to get everyone there. That's annoying. I can't really rush Alyssa past that. Also, I guess Rip Gaga's turn. I guess we can use it to reposition. But he'll be up here to fire down on stuff. Not the worst place to be. Well, now I'm not sure if Ryoga can get help from up here. He might be too far away. Whoops. We rolled too well. I guess they'll get to counterattack both either way, so let's lead in with them. Okay, never mind. By the time Ryoga reaches anyone, we might as well just be in this tunnel.
Okay.
Oh yeah, arm smash. And the ejection. Although, man, that actually means that Fan can't hit him. The luck rolls. Means he can still attack the weapon. Hey Jazz. Under an 8% platinum. Because why not? Okay, I'm gonna drop stream for about half a minute to hopefully fix the audio syncing, so be right back.